Well, at least we went with the right build to fight Aatrox at any rate. Actually, I was going to go back and buy Flask. I feel like Flask is better in this matchup.
We all have lines. I may have crossed one.
Ah, damn, I thought I'd get in range. Okay, level 2 by their jungler. By jungler, full clear. Wow, this feels familiar. Damn, if one more minion had walked in there. Ah! But if you're short trading, why not take Pressy attack? Do you realize how actually, like, massively fucking powerful Grasp of the Undying is? I feel like people don't really do the math in their head. Like, stop and think about this for a second. Every single trade, I do 4% of my health and damage, heal 2% of my health, then permanently get 5 health, which also then increases my health, healing me effectively for 5. So as of right now, I've already got 35 more HP off it, which... let's be honest, it's probably about as much damage as, Ow. Yeah, people focus so much on the tooltip. That's why old Conqueror got so much hate, because the tooltip actually just lied to you. Grasp the Undying's tooltip comes nowhere close to telling you how much impact it has. I mean, let's actually keep this in perspective, okay? Like, let's actually look at some of these smaller numbers that you might not even be thinking of. With 9 procs of Grasp, every shield I have is 9 more HP. Shit. Why didn't it dodge that turret shot? I jumped before the turret shot hit me. I mean, I got the kill, but I should have gotten the kill and lived. I'm just trying to keep Jarvan here right now. How did no one rotate to that? How did actually nobody? Atrox without revive equals Nasus. Wow, Twitchit. We see in its natural habitat just how dumb your average Twitch chatter is. So that was the only difference. The only difference between Renekton and Atrox. Literally the only difference was revive. That was it. I guess I waited too long to ult to reset turret aggro. It's just one of those stupid things that makes no sense. That you guys spam just because it's a meme. So, I mean, first off, Nasus and Renekton ult are very, very similar. But what's funny is none of the things that make Nasus ult and Renekton ult similar to each other, none of those things does Aatrox ult have. It doesn't have the health gain. It doesn't have the aura damage. So the two things that make those ults similar, Aatrox doesn't actually have. So what I was doing there, I mean, I died anyway, but what I was doing there is I needed to get him away from the wall, or else he would have blocked my E. I mean, I died anyway, but yeah. Okay, I don't know why it's playing me the Spanish version. Society needs rules. I mean, the thing is, enemy rampage. Well, at least in my opinion, the thing is that in League of Legends, there's enough similarities between pretty much everything. Because it's the same game. Like, every champion is playing League of Legends, you know? So, obviously, you're gonna get champions that follow the rules. And I just wanted to get that fucking gold. That kinda sucks. I'm just gonna go get my Trinity. Big power spike, big deeps. It's not like I can beat him right now anyway. He's gotten too much support from the jungler. I thought that'd go better. Their bot lane's kind of ridiculously fed. Thank you. Well, that worked out. Wait. Are you guys telling me that Camille's Q no longer turns Sheen into true damage? Because that's kind of a major bug. Like, kind of a really major bug, actually. And I think that seems to be what's happening here. Yeah. Huh. Yeah. Why couldn't I just ult? What the fuck? I just wanted to ult. God damn it. It's a fucking game. Can I explain why Max E on Camille is better? Wow, it's this question again. Because maxing my damage, gap closer, stun, attack speed boost, escape move seems like a pretty good idea, Twitch chat. I don't know about you, but you know. Twitch chat be like, yeah, but Q does a lot of damage. You should max it because it does damage. It does damage no matter if you max it or not, Twitch chat. Its damage is based on total AD. Okay. If he had just moved a little bit and gotten his shield, man. Huh. That worked. Color me surprised.
As
I'm not sure how I could have outplayed that. I feel like I kind of played that as far as I could. Yeah. Yeah, so I'm not getting the Trinity conversion on my queue. Maybe they did that on purpose? I don't know. With two dead, we lose Baron. Were they not coming to defend the turret? Could I really just have taken that turret? What the fuck? Ah. Kaisa just did 1,276 damage. I question you, Riot. Why? Dude, cue the minions. You have more Q stacks. Yeah, that bug is actually costing me a bit.
Yeah.
I don't actually know if I beat Aatrox late game with my
They will greet you as heroes.
How did we not kill Jarvan? You, a stupid Twitch chatter. Aatrox is useless without revive. Everyone else. Wait, he had a revive? I never used it. I actually can't do any damage through Soraka. Holy shit. Like, all my damage gets reduced to zero. I think I should have just kept pushing. Oh, shit me. By walking away, I actually killed myself because Cho'Gath then hit his Q by missing it. I feel like we need to get picks, but I don't know how our team comp gets picks. Mostly just me. I can try to split push, but... Shouldn't Hecarim be beating Jarvan by this stage in the game? And there's a large CS advantage too. Grasp is at 33 right now, which means 165 HP. I can really feel that loss of damage right now. Without my Trinity making my, or sorry, without my Q making my Trinity true damage, I don't think I can beat Aatrox late game. Like, every single Q, I'm missing like 120 damage. That adds up pretty quickly. No, I'm not missing 250 damage, because if he had zero armor, I'd be missing no damage. It's Ninja Tabby. Ninja Tabby and his armor mitigation. So, what is my late game damage? How much damage does Camille have late game?
How much would that be? You as heroes.
It'd be like... probably like 120, 130, yeah. But the thing is, I'm missing that much damage each time I use my second Q. Thank you, Deathstroke X. Yeah, that's why I couldn't really get Aatrox's health bar to go down. Because, like, think about it this way. The amount of damage I'm missing is the amount of damage I would be applying that would actually cause his health to go down. Missing a little bit of damage against a drain tank drastically lowers your survival, or, well, drastically lowers how much damage you'll deal to him. Because, okay, let's say Aatrox is healing 100 health per second, and I'm dealing 150 damage per second, right? So I'm doing 50 damage per second. If I lose 30 damage, I'm not losing 30 damage, I'm losing 60% of my damage.
Surpass the frailty.
Thank you, Zano. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, so basically, even losing 300-400 damage there starts taking him out of the kill range.
We'll be right back.